identity. That's why any time that you have a father, biological father, and a spiritual father who have been delegated by God to give identity. Your biological father gives identity on earth. Your spiritual parents gives you identity in heaven. That's the same father who will stand. That's why Paul was saying to Timothy that Timothy, my son. Timothy what? I stand before you that I prayed for you. We have today the greatest. Nilikuwa namuuliza mama moja aliniambia juzi. Anafanya police, she's a shady. Akaniambia the biggest challenge that they have so far kwa watoto ambao hawana mababa, their majority ndio criminals, wanakuwa kwa crime ya robbery with violence, wao ndio wanakuwa in petty crimes, any crime you can call it. Wakaniambia that is the number one challenge. Listen to this. That's why Jesus, no matter as God said himself, he was God, and impartia Mary, Jesus Christ, by inspiration of the Holy Spirit, akapata mimba kupitia Roho Mtakatifu. But Joseph was to be there, to be identified as a source. Bwana asifiwe sana. Bwana asifiwe. Children are not supposed to be given identity by their mothers. I know that one is very hard. Bwana asifiwe sana. Children are not supposed to be given, and that's why, let me tell you, anywhere in Israel, from Ammon into Manasseh, the children who, their mothers were also in control of them. These are the children who did a lot of havoc. They went against God in many ways. As much as people think that mothers are the one who take children to the church, but the whole truth in Israel, the mothers are the one who misled most of their children. Biological, they give identity. Listen to this. In Luke chapter number 1, verse number 63, the Bible says, when John was born, when John was given birth, when John was born by his parents, the father alikuwa bubu, Zachariah. Maandiko inasema, the clanmen and everybody came to name him. Amutaje, wamutaje John. Bwana asifiwe sana. What did the Bible says? After that, can we read Moses to number, let's start from 60s. What happened from number 50, actually 58. Let's start from 58. 58, then we go down. Can we read it very carefully? Well, okay, let's read 1, 2, 3, let's go. The next verse. In other words, the neighbors wanted to bypass. What did the mother say? What? I love that woman. That is a woman of grace. Same as grace. What did they say? His mother answered that this guy shall not be called after his father. He shall be called John. But this name, it was given by Zachariah. By what? Let's go. What the Bible says? Unasikia? Mapepo ya kuduplicate relatives. Unanielewa? Jesus Christ. Demons ya kuduplicate relatives. Now, people know. Mama kasema, huyu mtoto ataitwa John. And they did not know the meaning of the word John. Listen, let's go to the next verse. Verse 3 now. Verse 63. And they all, I said they all did what? They all were surprised. So even naming, doing what? Because women could name children as by circumstances. They don't care what will happen for the child after all. They didn't. So biological parents, they give identity. Same identity. Identity. It is the father. Who knows? Who knows? Listen to this. Leah Ariposa Reuben, maandiko inasema, she's the one who named Reuben, meaning that now my husband will love me more. That's the name, ni maana ya Reuben. Akasema mume wangu atanipenda sana kuliko vile ananipendaga. So akamuita Reuben. That's what the Bible says. But if father, what happened later? After he named the firstborn, maandiko inasema the same Reuben is the one that who went to his father's concubine and slept with them. Listen that. Anytime that you give the authority, women, they can give birth, they can do everything, but God never gave them an opportunity and even a source. Because this is a very controversial. Especially when you come to single mothers, single women, in some places of that kind, nobody will listen to you. Why? Because they say you are a controversial, because they say we are equal. There is nowhere. Women are the last born of God. After God created everything on the face of the earth, the last person he created was Asante Mzendubi. Who was the last born ya Mungu? If. So last born is yoye anakuwaga na say, to anajaribu. That's why I tell women, when you pray, God listens faster than this when the other people pray. When men pray, God really takes some time to listen. But if a woman pray, women who are called by God's name and they really desire to pray, when they pray, God listens faster. Why? Si unajua wale wako na last born hapa, si unajua hiyo? Last born akiongea, unaweza simama? Nauliza, unaweza simama? Listen to this. Identity, listen. There is one woman that's called Rachel. In Genesis 5 verse 18, this woman was naming a child after she was giving birth. What does the Bible say? When she was trying to name his child, when this woman was trying to name the child, a father called Jacob came and said, no, this woman shall not call my child. He will not call him that Benoin. That child will be called who? Can you read it loudly what the Bible says? She called the name of his son Benjamin what? I said she called him what? Benoin. The meaning of the word Benoin, it means the son of my sorrow. The son of what? What did the father came? The man who was the father, he changed it immediately. Bwana asiwe sana. Ndio unaona hata kabila zingine watu wakioanaga, wanagawanaga watoto. Ati huyu anaitwa nini? Kibranget. Huyu anaitwa Ondie Kinyuka Kota. Huyu anaitwa, yani they started dividing children among the tribes. Unajua hivyo? But in the real sense, a father is the one that who gives identity. Gives what? I say the one who gives what? Is the one that was supposed to give identity to the children. Because identity crisis that we have. When I say in America right now, 70% of the Americans who have given out their children, wameza, out of wedlocks, most of them single mothers, and almost 80% to 90% in American jail cells, zote, they are habited by those black people who have given out their children. And the reason why they love Democrat Party in our tetea, wamama wale wanaza, bila wababa, na wanachukua watoto, wanasema ni waza watoto narudi wanakuwa criminals. Even in America, they have already go and search the statistics in America. Now listen to this. Another thing is you must understand that when a father who gives the identity is the one that who shows the children on how to worship. If you are not careful, the Bible says in the book of Genesis 22, when you start reading verse number 3, Isaac and his father Abraham, they went to worship God. They went, Isaac and the father. So it is the father that who directs the way of worship in the family. Bwana asifiwe sana. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Rachel aliiba miungu ya baba yake akabeba. Na unaniambia angezaa watoto hao wote. Si angewaambia waabudu miungu ya baba yake? Excuse me. Biblia inasema, you know what Ruben Jacob said wakati Ruben yani Labani anakuja kutafuta miungu zake, alisema anybody ambaye atapatikana. Unajua what did Jacob say? Jacob alisema anybody atakayepatikana ako na hiyo miungu na akufe. So Laban was a very ruthless old man ambaye ana adabu. Maandiko yanasema aliingia straight hema kwa hema, akaingia hema ya Rachel, akamwambia Rachel, akamwambia my father, I am on my periods, I can also amesema. Mzee akasema, have you seen those wazee hawana adabu? Akamwambia stand up at you in your periods, stand, because this woman kumbe alikuwa amekalia hiyo miungu ya, that lady, she was very very demonic. Amekalia miungu ya baba yake, anajifanya ako na period and she was pregnant. Now baba yake akamuinua. Sijaona baba mukatiri kama Laban. Sema haleluya. Baba mbaya kuliko mwenye ati anapenda. Unajua kuna hiyo pepo ati oh, kuna watoto wa baba, kuna watoto wa mama. You know boys are for girls, for mama, guys girls for baba. That is nonsense. Hii juzi unaona ati msichana analala na baba yake, whether it is true or not true. Lakini hata hapa Nakuru nimeambiwa kuna wengi wako hapa, baba amezalisha. What is wrong, Mzendu? It is because of the identity crisis. There is a level that the parents are, because they are demonic of shame, that are following the fathers and they are following the mother. They want to shame both of them. Maandiko yanasema Ruben akaenda, yani Laban akaenda akamuinua. Alipomuinua akapata miungu, akasema, akaambia Jacob. And Jacob had already spoken, whoever shall be found with the girls of Laban, helped him die. Do you know what? After this woman gave birth his last born son, that was Benjamin, she died. Alimtoto alitoka na huyo mama akakufa. They died, both of them. You can imagine a identity crisis. Because every time, if you are not very very careful, if you are not very careful, the devil will take advantage of the children. And that's why we are coming in as a generation that is going to take back the fathers back to their sons. Sema amen. Aye, jamani sema amen. Can we read the book of Malachi chapter number 4 very quickly? Very Malachi chapter number 4 verse number 6 quickly. Malachi chapter number 4 verse number 26. Verse 6, sorry. Malachi 4:6. Listen, can you read it loudly? Can you read all of us? Of the children, do what? Unaweza pata mama anageuza watoto kabisa, watoto wanakalia baba yao. Even when the children raise their hands to fight their father in the name of the instigation of their mothers, that is a curse that will never go under. Do you know that? It's a curse that enemy will never allow you to enjoy, because every time we must understand, tuelewe kwamba every single moment when we are talking about fathers, a father is a source, is a foundation, is the one that will keeps identity. Bwana asiwe sana. Singeweza ati niamke asubuhi sasa mke wangu atikae ndiye amebeba mtoto miezi 9 alafu akuja muite Njoroge wa Thiong'o. Inikiwa when I'm still alive. Alafu zikuja upige makofi kwa hospitali. No. Because any responsibility. No. Who tells you? People may tend to think that children belong to the mother and because the mother breastfeed them. But let me tell you, identity crisis in the whole world is as a result of the fathers who does not know exactly what they are doing. That's why we are living in a society whereby people have forgotten wamekata kuelewa. Listen to this. Now write down the second, the third father that I did not tell you. The third father. The father in Christ. Father in what? Andika chini tafadhali, because I will take you through again the next time when we are in. The father in Christ. This father in Christ is the one who showed you the ways of Kristo. Huyu aliye kuongoza katika njia za Kristo. Akakuintroduce kwa Yesu. Bwana asifiwe sana. He may not be necessarily your spiritual father, but it is the father that introduced you. Unanielewa? Nani aliye kujulisha? Nani aliye kuomlisha kwamba kuna Yesu? That's a father. That's a father in Christ. Another one is called a spiritual father. Now this is the most important person.
is the one that is responsible for you here on earth, and is the one responsible you here even in heaven. Spiritual fathers are the ones who have the strength and the capacity that you can speak. Simon, who was in the temple, he had the spiritual father of Jesus Christ. Maandiko nasema when Jesus was brought in, because alijua wazazi wake, wakati Yesu alipoletwa, Biblia inasema ya kwamba alisema, now the servant of God can die. The servant of God can do what? I have seen the Messiah. I have seen the Savior. I have seen. There is one we call father in the ministry. That one you may not know. That is only known by all the preachers like us. There is another one we call a substitute father. A substitute father, you should give him his honor. Is the one who came in when your father was a drunkard. When your father drove your mother out of their home. A substitute father can be your uncle, can be your guardian, can be your grandmother. You don't call him a mother. You call him a substitute father. Bana siwezan. Huyo msendubi naye lazima umpe baraka zake. Ndu experience baraka zile unaitaji. A substitute father. Hiyo ndio watu wanasahau sana. Mtu alikusaidia umetoka from primary. Wakati mama yako amefukuzwa. Ama ako barabarani. Hata baba wakambo. Sasa ubaya wengine wanaangukiaga baba wakambo wanaacha baba original. I'm sorry to quote Margaret Wanjiru, and I disconnect watoto kutoka kwa kamangu. Even if hata amekuliwa jigas, he's a father. That blood runs through that kid. That blood, you can never disassociate it. That blood is there. It's there. So when you get problem, especially watoto wakike, wakipata substitute father, wanasawigi baba yao original. One pastor juzi ameniambia last 3 weeks ago aliniambia mke wake mama yake aliolewa na yeye akaenda kwa nyumba nyingine kwa mwanamke mwingine, yani wakaenda kama mama bibi ya pili. Alipoenda kalinga bibi ya pili, mama huyo akalelewa, wakalelewa na huyo baba wakambo, wakakua, wakasoma, wakamaliza shule. Sasa wakati wa juzi huyo mama ametoka mwenyewe akaenda kutafuta baba yake. Akaenda kumukuta huko mbali Kitale matunda ndani. Akamkuta ndani ya matunda mdani mzee. Ati alipokuta huyo mzee alimwacha mtoto akiwa 6 years. Now the lady is 30 something years. Si nimeona hata juzi kwa gazeti, there is one Philip Ocheng, a writer, amesema amepata mtoto wake after 54 years alizaa America na akaachana na akakuja Kenya. Let me tell you, that blood that runs through that, it will never die. I say it will never die. I say to a substitute father is also very important. A substitute father. Mzendubi, anko yako aliyekushika mkono wakati mama yako alikuwa na mahangaiko hata ajui kitu, akakulipia school fees peke yake. Unafikiri school fees mama yako angeweza peke yake alipe? Wakati kuna shida shuleni, anakushika mkono, anakupeleka kwa niaba ya baba yako, anakufikisha shule. Even that stepfather is very important. You need to bless him. I say you need to bless him. I say you need to bless him. Tuna kisasi ambacho kiko very ungrateful. Akipendi shukurani, kinapenda lawama. Another one, verse number 7, father. Number 7, father. Iliwambia, number 6 was father in the ministry. Amu kuandika. Number 1 is was a heavenly father. Number 2 is a biological father. Number 3 is a father in Christ. Number 4 is a spiritual father. Number 5 is a father in the ministry. Number 6, a substitute father. That is, I'm saying, is your uncle, your guardian, your stepfather, any other father. Those ones they demand. Number 7 is father-in-law. They call them father-in-law. Yani baba wa sheria. Baba wa nini? Ongea na mimi vizuri. Baba wa nini? Baba wa sheria. Hambishani na yeye. Mukikosana, You don't argue.
Do you argue with your father-in-law?
Unaweza hata kama amekukashirika mpaka juu.
Can you stand against your father-in-law? Naonaga some people who are very idiotic, who does not know, not leave alone the culture.
Standing. Moses.
The man, the Bible says, Moses left his children, his two children and the wife Zipporah. He left them in the care of his father-in-law. Moses, father-in-law akauliza, na huyu kijana anakuwa mhubiri?
Where is she?
Maandiko inasema, they started searching for Moses, the pastor. The father-in-law ameshika watoto wawili, anasema, kulingana na desturi yetu, kulingana nini? Watoto wakai hapa. Biblia inasema, akashika watoto wa Moses, na bibi yake Zipporah, akawaambia tuende, in a mission of searching your father. Search what? Alipopata Moses, akamwambia brother, nimekukuta hapo unaendelea na washirika wanakusumbua. You know the father-in-law waited for Moses to talk to him.
It is very evil
that your father-in-law, my father-in-law comes here, ati niko na watu kwa hiyo ofisi nikae hivi sasa na yeye akae kwa line because nimekuwa mkubwa. When you are demon possessed, full of the devil, you can make your father-in-law wait. That's what Moses did.
Moses made his father-in-law to wait for him.
Unajua father-in-law aliingia asubuhi mapema sana. Unajua father-in-laws wale wa genuine hawakujagi nyumbani saa 6. Hey. Ama inakuwaje mzee Ndubi?
Father-in-law ana saa 12
unasikia baba hako nje. Unauliza kuna any problem? No. Why? Because he want to go back. Alalagi kwa watoto. Alali wa? Si wale father-in-law anakujaga kwa watoto hata ndio na anatoa koti anaangi kwa penye baba anaangi. Their father-in-law, yani baba katika sheria, baba katika nini? Jinsi ya kumusalimia, jinsi ya kuongea na yeye, unaongea na adabu nyingi, hata kama siku hiyo adabu imepotea, akionekana unajiorganize, unafanya? Ama inakuwaje ndugu zangu?
Unakuwa na mipango,
uzungukaji, father-in-law na mother-in-law wakipitaga, you are very careful. In fact, from where I come from, mother-in-law hawaingiagi kwa nyumba, wanaingiaga nje, wanakaa nje, they don't ingia nyumba ya watoto. Na hiyo si kidemon, hiyo ni kimaandiko, because anazuia. Mother-in-law akikuona uchi, dirangu, you are under a curse.
Extremely a curse.
Na si ati ni culture, it is real.
So, a father-in-law,
Moses came, maandiko anasema, baba-in-law, Moses aliingia asubuhi. Aka watch Moses kutoka asubuhi mpaka jioni. Moses hajatokea, amekaa tu. Watu wanaingia counseling, wanaingia counseling. Alipomaliza ndiye akaambiwa, "Oh, kuna mzee mmoja pale ako na watoto wawili na mama mmoja." Na niwe anaona. Kuamka akaona own father ndio akamsalimia. Akamwambia, "Boss, chukua watoto wako na bibi yako, nimekuletea. Wachana na kusumbua, nimekuletea. Lakini nimeona uko na kazi nyingi sana." Akamwambia, "Hii kazi unajipea, si utakufa haraka, hata ndio sababu umeabado ni bibi na watoto." When you have a very genuine father-in-law, he gives you proper and a good advice to take care of your family. Akamwambia, "Sasa kile naona, do you know the advice Moses kuchukua wazee 70 kugawa roho yake kwake? It was an advice from his father-in-law." Yeye alimwambia, "Sasa badala naona vile unateseka, maana tangu nikuja hapa asubuhi hujaniona. Uko busy na washirika throughout. Na washirika ndio walikufanya hata usione Kanani. So brother, hawa ndugu zako, watoto wako ndio wa muhimu. Sasa kitu utafanya, hesabu wazee tu kama akina Ndubi, wazee wa miaka hivyo, roho yako gawa juu yao. Na waambie hiyo roho ikiwa juu yako, yako ikuwa juu yao, wakaage vikundi vikundi, hii crowd utamalizana. Otherwise utakufa." And that's how Moses did, as the instruction of the father-in-law. Father in what? Mbaba katika sheria. Baba katika nini? Father of delegation. It's father of the mother of delegation. It was an advice from the father-in-law. He came very early. He came. And you know what? The children of Moses disappeared in the horizons because they never went to the ministry, even as he was a man of God, a man who God loved so much. But his children never went to the ministry. And that's why sometimes, even kuna kipindi, ukionaga pasa anakuwa mkatiri, watu wanaonaga pasa ni vuruku. But ukweli ni kwamba, even when he's taking care of his own children, you know what? People want everybody to, their children to be taken care of, but the pastor's children be neglected. That's what happened to Moses. That's what happened to him.
As great as Moses was, as big as Moses had a ministry, but they had one problem. They never had time with the children and the wife. In fact, the first time they got married, that was all. Another one. The father in Christ, these ones are normal people. The father in Christ. Kuna father in Christ kwa mfano, wazee wale wa zamani. Wale ambao walitulea kama akina Bishop Eli. Sasa, these are father in Christ. Yani ni wazee. We may not, but we owe allegiance to them 100% because these are the people, not only that introduced us to the ministry, but these are the people who gave us the grace to understand what is happening within our spiritual life. Banaswesan. Another one is the father in the movement. Father in the movement, awa ni wale waliokuwa wazee pia kama akina Kayo. We don't, when we see akina Dr. Joe Kayo, my friend, we cannot experience and enjoy ministry in Kenya by any standard without their movement, who came, risked their life. Against a tidy, our Catholics who are very strong. These are the men we call the father in the movement. Wale wasee waliosimama kidete na wakapigana mpaka Kenya katika sehemu za kiroho. They are the one who are called the pioneers who broke the ground. They broke the ground. How do they break the ground? Listen to this. This one, they are very, very, very important. And also, the last one. Tell me the last one. Please, tell me the last one. The last one. The father in the movement is the father in Christ. Number three, they will be a father in Christ. But there is a father in Christ in the movement. And also there is a father in the faith. Where Paul was telling Timothy that my son Timothy in the faith. Now, the last one is a father, the last one. The father in sin. And the father in what? Father in sin. Father of sin. That's the devil. It's called the father. It's called what? It's called what? Don't ignore him. Don't do what? Don't do what? The father of sin. Huyo ni wa muhimu sana ndugu yangu. Huyo ni wa muhimu sana. Kwamba you are carefully, watchfully, faithfully taking care of him. Rest, he deceives you. These are the fathers. Different kinds of fathers. Listen to this. His father. Now, listen to this. Father, in other senses of it, when they give father also, they give security. They give what? Security. Another one is sense of belonging. Sense of belonging. Sahi, kuna watu wanatumiaga majina ya the Nyandusis. For example, I'm just giving an example. Kuna mtu nilipata Nairobi wanatumia jina Muigai. Family ya Muigai. Akaniambia sisi ni family ya Muigai kina Kenyatta. Yani because of the big name, they want to have what you call a sense of beginning. Yani they want to have a belonging. They want to have a beginning. And you must take care. Take care. Take care. Take care. I tell the people, the devil is very cunning. Let me tell you. Kama wewe uko huku na unajua, you are not connected. Paul anasemaje? There may be over 10,000 instructors. How many? How many instructors? 10,000. And let me tell you, Mzendubi, listen to this. Listen to this. If you want a blessing, connect your father in the faith, and your biological father, they are all alike. Hawa ni watu wameshikana pamoja. And the enemy man, because what when your father curses you, when Reuben was cursed by his father, that was Jacob. The man who came to reverse the curse, it was Moses the pastor. I said it was Moses the pastor. Moses was a spiritual father, though the Aaron and the rest of the people were all the priests in that time, but Moses was a spiritual father for the entire Israel. These are the people that you must understand, that you must look at the level of understanding. A level of understanding. How? Because all of us, what I wanted to go up, tunajua. Let me tell you, honestly speaking, there are some blessings that you may look for them everywhere. You'll never get them. There are blessings that you may look them everywhere. Everywhere, every place, every corner, every direction. Everywhere you look for those directions, for those blessings, but you never get them unless the spiritual father, that is the one that was supposed to speak. Listen to this. Chapter number 27, verses number 4 in the book of Genesis. Chapter number 27, the book of Genesis. Chapter number 27, verse number 4, the book of Genesis. What does the Bible say? Please, can you read it? Just a minute. That is how sometimes women go around and mislead their children, because when Rebecca went around and she stole the blessings of his firstborn, because he did love the firstborn, he went and told Jacob that this is, and you know what, if you continue reading it down, uyo mama ndiye alisemaga akasema, even if your father, listen, the boy was very careful. Go to the next verse. Moses mtoto alikuwa very careful, alimwambia mama nikienda kwa mzee na mzee ajue sio mimi, si hadhani laani. Mama alisemaje? Akasema hiyo laana niko tayari kufanya, niko tayari kuibeba. Can you read it please? Now listen loudly. In the presence of the Lord before I die. The next verse. Unasikia vile mama na mislead mtoto? Anamwambia, thou my son, obey what? Obey my voice. Obey what? Do according to my command. There are things that we are suffering today. Some of them are misled. Anamwambia, tafadhali. Hiyo ni vumbi tu, si ati mvua.